Hello, my dear friends. Today I wanted to share with you my January favorites, and these are just a couple of things that I have found to bring so much value to my life and that I have really enjoyed using this past month. And so I wanted to share with you. Before I go into it, I wanted to say that none of this is sponsored. These are just things that I've tried, that I've discovered either on my own or through recommendations from friends, and I've really got a lot of benefit out of these. Maybe you can get the benefits in your own life. So let's get started. The first January favorite that I want to share is this compostable bin. So it's a really cute little bin with a wooden frame and a stainless steel tin in the center, and it has a nice little lid that you can open. I'm not gonna open it fully because it's actually full of compostable things right now. But yeah, I love this tin because it sits right on top of your kitchen counter, and it's just so convenient in terms of being able to just open the lid when you need to put something in there while you're chopping, you know, onions or garlic, and you just wanna throw it away really quick. Yeah, I love it. I've been looking for something like this for a couple of years now. I've been experimenting with cans that are battery operated, where if you hover your hand over the sensor, it'll open the lid for you, and that's a nice no-touch solution. But I just didn't like the way that it looked on my counter, and so I ended up moving those to the bathroom and just wasn't composting for the longest time because I didn't have a great container for that. With an airtight lid. And so yeah, I found this past week at World Market, and for me I was like, oh my goodness, this is the solution I've been looking for, and Dan and I have been loving it, and we use it every single day. And so yeah, I will put a link down to it below so that you can check it out too. So yeah, if you're finding any other solutions that are working for you while you're composting, I'd love to hear those too. Composting is relatively new for me, but I just feel really good about it, knowing that the waste that doesn't have to go into landfill is in fact going towards composting and could be reused very soon in terms of a more sustainable and renewable energy. The second January favorite I wanted to share is this book called Healing Mushrooms. It's by, I'm gonna butcher the name, Taro Isocalpelia. but basically this is a book written by the founder of Four Sigmatic. So his company produces teas, coffees, and powders that are made from mushroom extract. And what I love about this book is it goes into the reasons for why a lot of these mushrooms are so healthy for you. And it introduces 10 species of mushrooms, and it talks about their nutritional benefits and the other benefits that you can get from eating them. So that ranges from boosting your immune system to improving your skincare to increasing your energy. And I always knew that mushrooms were a health food. I love eating mushrooms too. I mean, eating them all my life. It's a big part of Chinese cuisine too. But I never stopped to think about the medicinal properties of mushrooms, and I definitely didn't know that there was a book written for a Western audience. And so I love the stories that he shares about how mushrooms have helped other people's lives. And there's also some amazing recipes in here that I can't wait to try in terms of incorporating mushrooms into your day-to-day cooking, in baking recipes, in drinks. And yeah, after reading this book, Dan and I have been buying more mushrooms at the grocery store. It's now a staple part of our diet. So we're eating a lot of oyster mushrooms, maitakes, shitakes, and cordyceps. I personally love cordyceps. I just do a little bit of salt, pepper, and olive oil, and it just tastes so rich and decadent, and it just tastes like there's so much butter in it. It's so rich, but actually it's just olive oil, salt, and pepper, and all that delicious flavor is coming from the mushroom itself. So I will put a link to this book down below and some references to mushrooms that we are trying recently and just loving. The third January favorite that I wanted to share is this chai tea. It's by Blue Lotus Chai, and it is specifically a rooibos masala chai. And what I love about this is it's a great alternative to coffee. I have been very sensitive to caffeine all my life, but I love having a little boost of it in the morning when I wake up, and chai and tea in general is just a great way to get a little kick of energy in the morning without having a cup of coffee, which also comes with a lot of other side effects. Like, it can be a little bit dehydrating, and I find that the caffeine levels are just a little bit too intense for me. Like, chai is just so good for you because it has all these different spices that have additional health benefits. It's anti-inflammatory, it has a lot of antioxidants, and it just tastes so good in the morning when I mix it with a little bit of nut milk. It also comes with a little wooden spoon, which is so cute, and it gives you the perfect amount of tea that you can just put into your cup. Yeah, so I start my day every day with this now, and I have been for about a month, and I'm just loving it. So I'm about to run out soon, and I'm gonna start my next jar. This is made by Soleil Toujours, and it's a Set and Protect Micro Mist with 30 SPF. What I love about this is it's spray on, so you can put it on after you're done with your makeup, and it works really well as an additional makeup setter. Additionally, this is using pretty clean ingredients, so I love that this is reef safe. So I took this with me to our last trip to Maui, and I felt good knowing that the ingredients in here are reef safe and not gonna be adding pollutants to the environment. It is waterproof up to 80 minutes, and yeah, I'm almost done with this container, so gonna be looking forward to replacing it. The only thing that I wish would be different about this product is that it does come in a plastic bottle. So I'm gonna see if there's other solutions out there that are in a more sustainable bottle, like glass, maybe a larger size too, so that I don't have to replace it as much. But yeah, if you have any recommendations for good sunscreens that are sprayable in good environmentally safe containers and that are also reef safe, please share with me, and I would love to try those out too. So the last January favorite that I wanted to share with you is something very simple. It's just raw organic cashews. And this is something that is a newly found love for me. I had been eating a lot of almonds and walnuts over the last 2 years, but cashews was not something that I really dived into until recently. I get these at our local grocery store in the bulk food section. So as you can see, I get a big amount, and I stock them into these glass mason jars. What I love about cashews is they're a great source of protein and nutrients for anyone who is leaning towards a plant-based diet. I have been cutting down my red meat consumption, and so this past month I've been leaning towards nuts and cashews for protein, for healthy fats, and other nutrients that I know my body needs. Cashews are great for lowering cholesterol, and they can also boost your immune system because they contain copper and zinc, which our body needs. We've just been incorporating cashews into our daily meals, whether we're sprinkling it on top of breakfast, we've been baking them into oat bars, we're gonna start experimenting with making our own nut butter. So yeah, I'm just excited to be integrating cashews more into our daily diet. So yeah, that's it for January. These are some of my January favorites that I hope you can get to enjoy as well. I would love to hear some of your favorites that you've discovered this month too. If you have any, please share with me down below. I would just love to hear from you and what's working well for you in your life right now. Thanks so much, guys.